Can I help you?
Just having a look.
How's the bounty hunting going? Looks like you've had a
few years here. How's it going?
Yeah.
Hey,
kill him, dude.
Kill
them
all. Hey, how's it going?
How's the bike business going, Zanny?
Hey, how you been?
Hey, Alka.
What the hell? Get back to work.
Looks like someone isn't doing their job.
That's a good one.
Get the lead out. You want to eat? Come on, get to work.
You could use a gun like that. Find me if you need anything else.
Hey, no.
You need something?
I'm getting to work. No. Damn it. Stop. Knock it off.
I'm gonna look around.
That right there? Good piece. Come by if you still need something. You seeing you, Deke?
See ya, Alki.
Hey, Deacon.
Alki.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Zanny. Keeping your hands clean?
Hey, see you, Deke. What can I get for you?
O'Brien. It's goddamn O'Brien. What did he say? Metolius Springs? Metolius Springs. Yeah, I know where that is. Here we go.
Hey, let me in. It's one of the drifters. Let him in.
Hey, Deke.
Hey, Manny.
Thank you. This should last you for a while. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. I'll wrap that up for you. Should have more stuff later. All right, I'm seeing you.
Deacon.
What's up?
I taught English. Shamal came to college.
That's it.
Anyway, we heard all this screaming.
Oh, hey.
Thought it was a shooting at first.
Jazzy.
I didn't think I'd see you around so much.
Damon.
A lot of freaks.
What can I get you? Not buying today.
It was a riot.
Later, man.
Hey, been seeing you around more.
Manny, what's going on?
Cool. Need anything else? Good choice, man. Good choice. This should last you for a while. Look me up if you need anything else.
Let me get the gate.
Caught a break. That Nero radio might actually be useful. I know where they're going tomorrow.
Wait, I thought you said you couldn't take them on.
No, I can't. But with a little luck, I can get to their chopper without being seen and...
Give them hell, brother. Remember what Jack used to say? Don't ride faster than your guardian angel can fly.
Like I said, Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit. Deacon out.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain Cope. Don't give me any of your Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs.
Thank you.
Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, then. Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
You got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
Oh, no, that's okay. You wounded him.
Okay.
See the blood spots? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Then follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay. You know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look, Cope, Boozer and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you've got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Let me get the gate.
I got parts,
if you're looking.
Alright.
Back to work.
For our lives. Ooh, that sounds crazy.
Hey.
My ass in
my what's going on?
The past year. Nothing out in the shit but a whole lot of sorry.
What's up?
What's up? How's it going, Booze Man?
Fine, goddammit. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. Could use some more meat if you get a chance.
Oh, shit. Okay. I guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
You remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Cope? Shit, I don't believe it. Thanks, Deke.
See you, Booze Man. All right, now I just gotta find some meat. Deer, bear, wolf, fuck, don't matter to me.
How's it going?
Life in the freak show.
I gotta get some sleep.
Yeah, okay.
Deke, this is Tucker. Stop by. I've got work for you.
Tuck, hey, okay. I'll see if I can make time. Deacon out.
Deacon St. John, this is Ada Tucker. Alki wanted me to tell you that the camp is thankful for all the runs you've been doing. We need all the help we can get.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grand... Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay an ambush. Hide where they need to go. Like a watering hole. Today, you're as likely to be prey as Hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're hitting up places we all need to go. Your grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. Put a snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come around. But careful. A headless snake can still bite. Especially when it ain't very dead. My grandfather outlived us all. Let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Great, Cope!
Damn it, so close. Anyone else hear that?
Lieutenant O'Brien, field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Demodocentrata serpentera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrion has indicated it should be just over here. Damn it, where is it? Ah! speculation as to Tabata's atrocities is confirmed.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and I would have happened something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes, I am.
How? How are you alive,
O'Brien? What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, refugee Nero camp.
Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb
Nero
for goddamn
Protocol
limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little spacesuit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead. So I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
And I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't. Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife? I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got out of the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Ryan,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Deke, you there?
Booze man.
few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Guess I should eye booze, man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay. Deke, you got your radio on? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Booze man, thank you, brother. I'll be by.
How's it going?
O'Brien. You out there? O'Brien! You son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. God damn it. You better get back to me, or I'm going to track you down.
You got that?
Oh, God damn it, come on!
Ryan!
Get back to me.
Deke, you there? Did you track down the chopper? Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah. Yeah, it was him.
Did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
I don't think she's still alive.
What? No. No, look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Where she died.
Hey, maybe you can finally, find some peace.
I don't need to find any peace. Jesus. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. In our supposed global utopia, instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that, all to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country?
Yeah.
They'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends. But they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope. But hey, whatever you say. Nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism. I mean, I could use a new bike right about now.
damn it! Stop him!
Here you are.
Come on.
gotta finish burning out these nests.
What the hell? That's worth checking out.
Freaks, get away from her!
Thank you.
get you now.
Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother.
What is she doing here for us?
Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother. She do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deacon out.
Yeah.